If I had to judge how good technically a chef is, I probably would ask him to do an omelette.
Hey guys, salut, it's Alex. So today is a day to remember. I'm gonna face one of the toughest challenges I have ever faced within my culinary journey. I'm gonna put myself to the test and see if I can wrap up the perfect 4 eggs omelette. So it's probably not very intimidating from your point of view, like eggs and pan, what could possibly go wrong?
Can we get a real chef here?
Well, it turns out that this dish is very tricky to master, and believe it or not, it is, widely regarded as the ultimate evaluation of a chef's expertise. No pressure at all, I am not nervous. Of course, before we jump straight into it, you and I need to be in pace about how high the omelette standards are. And for this, I think there is only one guy we need to check up. Okay, please say hello to Mr. Jacques Pépin. So if you're not familiar with the guy, Jacques Pépin is an international chef. He's also a TV personality. He has amazing skills. The guy actually cooked in the past with Julia Child, casually. You don't want to mess with the guy in terms of technique. In fact, the guy actually wrote a cookbook called La Technique. Anyway, this is him making the omelette.
It is difficult to make a real good omelette. And there is different type of omelette. I'm going to show you 2 types of omelette. A kind of country French omelette.
So I'm not
going to
focus on this one. I'm going to focus on the...
A classic French omelette.
This one.
This one, just a shy of omelette. So again, I want to bring this around and stir it up faster than I can. Here, I want to have a nice, then push it down, invert it to have an omelette, a classic omelette, which should be white like this or pale yellow.
Oh la 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 la. So this is the very reason why I made this video. In terms of omelette making, this is the standard. This is what I need to master. You know, there is a thin line between being bold and brave and being completely stupid. And I feel like I'm about to cross that line, like one way or another. Right, so I just don't want to overthink this too much. I just want to start making an omelette and see where I stand in all this. So I got myself a random pan. It's a bit beaten up, but it should be fine. And also I've got 4 eggs, which directly comes from my previous soft-boiled egg madness. Let's start. You know what? It should be fine. Let's just stop all the fuss about this. Three, two, one. I'm not sure about the shape. Also, my omelette is a bit brownish. It's quite rough. To be very honest, it is not very pointy. And now I think that the shape wasn't that bad. Disappointment set aside, I suggest we just go and watch that video again just to see if we got a chance to improve ourselves.
That pan, and this is what I want for an omelette, and as you see, it is
So for the record, I'm not sure that my pan was hot enough, but I am sure that my pan is a pan.
I want to bring...
it's impossible. I did not have this. It couldn't possibly be further than this beautiful shape.
Oh no.
This is probably the hardest blow regarding my omelette. Right, let's just pull ourselves back together. And I'm gonna address those problems one by one. Okay, so I just got a brand new non-stick pan. Hopefully things are gonna be smooth from now on. It's a very cheap one, but it was the only one with, the proper curve, and also the only proper one at 24 centimeters, and that is what matters the most. Well, indeed, to make the perfect omelette, you need the perfect pan to eggs ratio. And according to the man himself, Jacques Pépin, a 4 eggs omelette will be ideally made in a 24 centimeter pan or 9.5 inches. Well, the problem is that you can't just perform a cross multiplication between the number of eggs and the diameter of the pan. You see, eggs flattening in 2 dimensions, we need to use a 2-dimension values. And for this, the surface sounds legitimate.
The surface of a round pan is calculated like so. For a 24-centimeter span, it gives us 452 square centimeters, and that gives us the relation between the surface of the pan and the number of eggs you need. Which is not super useful because it's never mentioned on the package. Instead, we need to connect it to the diameter using the first equation.
And so we get a relationship between the diameter of the pan and the number of eggs, or the number of eggs and the diameter of the pan. Okay, don't worry, I made this so that you don't have to. I made a spreadsheet online, there's a link in the description box down below, and everything inside is already calculated. And now I think that we earned the right to cook our N eggs omelette in our D pan. First off, there is not half my omelette in the pan now thanks to this beautiful non-stick pan, and second, I didn't get that much color on this one, which is great! And now, of course, the main thing I'm not satisfied with is the shape. Light, fluffy, not seasoned, I forgot the salt, ah, I forgot the salt. So a quick word about the fork situation, I couldn't just wrap my head using this metally and pointy and edgy tool. So instead I switched to this wooden fork, which looks definitely less harmful, possibly a bit less practical, but whatever, I just don't want to scratch it anymore. I just don't want to scratch it anymore. Jacques Pépin, Jacques Pépin, Jacques Pépin. So from what I can see, there is a combination of two movements. With one hand is going back and forth, and with the other hand is doing an 8. Okay? It looks a bit like good scrambled eggs. Also, there is a gradient in the thickness. Very thin, way thicker. I'm really missing on the shape, and on the temperature, and the move, and the chives, and the Let's not give up that easily. I'm gonna practice way more. I need more eggs. I'm not gonna stop now. It would be stupid just to stop now. I'm so close to achieving the perfect omelette. Okay, what I need now, just to get my mind straight and ready for war, is the 12 commandments of the omelette. The optimal pan to eggs ratio. Whisk it good, medium plus heat. Butter should be bubbling, a little sizzling sound. The combo move. Shaking the pan, start flat, tilt off the heat. Very thin to thick, duck shape. Tap tap the handle, almost flat. Seal the omelette, invert it. So I got the theory right, I did practice a lot. The only thing left is just to make the perfect, classic omelette. And that is precisely what I'm gonna do right now. Delicate, fluffy, very, very soft. I don't know, I feel like I did the job properly right here. But at the same time, I know that my judgment is very much biased. The most legitimate judgment would come from Jacques himself. Truth is, I tried to reach out to Jacques Pépin over on Twitter without so much success, I'm afraid. And then I thought, why don't you guys help me out on this? The power of the community. Just tweet the guy and ask him to watch and judge my omelette. If you like this video, then please give this video a big thumbs up like it and share that over all your social media. This time I want to see your omelettes on social media, so don't forget to tag me in as well. Last people, click subscribe because I make new videos every week. It's always about the food, it's always about getting better and trying to be smarter in the kitchen. So take care, bye bye, salut.